My talk is focused on the use of single side NMR for evaluating the water mobility in hydrogel, suitable for the biocleaning of mural paintings. In recent years, the use of the Sulfo Vibrio vulgaris bacteria has become a common method for the removal of sulfate from stones. Through metabolic process, the sulfate-reducing bacteria are able to reduce sulfide ions in hydrogen sulfide according to this reaction. Compared to other traditional cleaning methods, this bacteria system offers several advantages, like the results in a more homogeneous removal of the surface deposit, and this system preserve the layer under salt efflorescence and black crust. The method is typically used on wall paintings by applying sulfate-reducing bacteria entrapped in hydrogel produce. Hydrogel systems are used as carriers for the solvent, allowing an increase of dwell time of the solvent, resulting in better cleaning without overwetting the painted surface. Therefore, it's very important to study the water mobility in gels formulation at the gel-well painting interface. In this study, three different hydrogel used at different concentration with the addition of sulfate-reducing bacterial formulation were applied on wall painting specimen affected by sulfate efflorescence and were investigated by single-side nuclear magnetic resonance. The portable nuclear magnetic resonance allow a fully non-invasive and non-destructive study of transport phenomena inside gels and allow to obtain information about the penetration rate of water through the porous matrix. These techniques combine an open magnet and a radio frequency coil to generate a sensitive volume external to the sensor, where the NMR signal is generated and detected. The magnetic field is applied to one side of the object, fully preserving the dimension of the manufact to be investigated, making this method a tool particularly suitable in the analysis of cultural heritage. In this study, relaxation time and cell diffusion coefficient were measured to study water compartmentalization and motion inside the gel. In addition, depth profile with a micrometric resolution were measured to evaluate water content and its penetration depth within the porous structure. Water transport in carbon gel, aponite, and gelan were investigated by measuring T1 and T2, relaxation times, and self-diffusion coefficients. The relaxation time of gel polymers depends on the several factors, like molecular weight, degree of branching, cross-link density, size of the side groups, and also temperature. Moreover, relaxation measurements are affected by both rotational and translational motion, whereas diffusion measurements are related only to the translational molecular displacement. In all gels, T2 were found to be always smaller than T1, indicated that water in gels exhibits a slowed motion due to the presence of the polymeric network. Transverse relaxation times measured in gel formulation indicate the presence of two water pools. And the fastest relaxing component related to bound water and the longest relaxing one related to free water. Hydrogen nuclei belonging to the bound water pool are possibly affected by hydrogen bonding interaction and or chemical exchange with the polymeric network of the gel. To study the translational motion of water molecules in gel bacteria system, the cell diffusion coefficient was also measured. With the unilateral NMR, the amplitude of spin echo generated under a strong uniform static magnetic field gradient can be used to detect the self-diffusion coefficient, a parameter which can reveal molecular dynamics and sample microstructure. The normalized echo attenuation was fit in according to this equation, and a self-diffusion coefficient of the water molecule was obtained from the slope of the plot. The self-diffusion coefficient found in the carbogel, gelan, and laponite gels are smaller than those observed in bulk water, indicated that the translational motion of water molecules is more hindered in gel than in bulk water. Portable NMR measurements can give information also about the capability of the gels to release water into the pore structure, and measurements of penetration depth of a gel can be obtained. To obtain the 1H NMR depth profile, the probe is placed on a lift, scanning the artifact step by step inside the object with a micrometric resolution. The amplitude of the 1H depth profile is directly proportional to the amount of absorbed water as a function of a depth scanned. Therefore, each experimental point represents the amount of water at the corresponding depth of measurements. Here are reported the depth profile obtained after 1 hour of application for the three different gels. Gel Langham showed the lowest amount of water absorbed by the specimen with respect to 1 hour application of carbogel and laponite. A similar trend is obtained after 4 hours of application. The profile showed that the trends dependent on the capability of the gel to release water into the porous media. Carbogel and laponite show a very similar trend with a large amount of water released after 1 hour and 4 hour application, whereas the gel and gum show the weakest water release capability. In conclusion, a unilateral single-side NMR is a powerful tool to evaluate in a fully non-invasive and non-destructive way water mobility and diffusion in gels used as a cleaning method. Three different types of gel bacteria formulation to be used as cleaning system for wall paintings were investigated. Transfer relaxation time measured in gel formulation indicate the presence of two water pools. The fastest relaxing water is involved in hydrogen bonding interaction and or chemical exchange with gel macromolecules, and the slowest relaxing one is rather free to move. Self-diffusion measurements demonstrated that the water translational motion is increasingly hindered as the average probability of a collision between water molecules and the gel network increase. The release and diffusion of water from gels formulation at the gel wall painting interface were investigated. Gel concentration and time of application of the gel to the wall paintings may be tuned for modulating the amount and the depth of penetration of the liquid phase through the porous network. The water absorption and its distribution penetration in the support depend not only on the physical, chemical, and rheological properties of the gel, but can be also affected by the properties of the support to which the gel is applied. This study is part of a more extensive study aimed at obtaining an analytical protocol for establishing directly in situ the performance of cleaning systems. I would like to thank my worker and you for your kind attention.